In this video, we're going to be painting like Paul Klee with fun word art. This is going to be a fun lesson, so use your imagination, select your words, pick your favorite paint colors. I'm going to be using acrylic paint, and make some amazing artwork for your wall. Welcome to the Ayala Art I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend, Martha. If you're art inclined, love acrylic paint, art journals, and mixed media, this is your channel. I love the childlike style of Paul Klee. He makes all kinds of playful images, the way he plays with the color, the way he plays with the shapes. It is just so interesting to me. I just really love it. I love the way that is abstracted enough to be just forms and shapes, but it is also containing some other figures like a fish or a tree or houses or just different things. Look for him online and check his name, check his work, and just get fascinated with all the colors and things he does with his poetry and his words and his imagery. It's very, very nice. So for this, let us start with art, organized by B. I am going to be working on my list of words, and I'm going to be using a large watercolor paper. It is probably around 17 by 12 or something like that. In the image that I found of his work, which by the way, later on, I found another person inspired by the same painter, Paul Klee, and it was like a combination of words for the year and dreams. I'm going to put his link, Imperfect Paintings, in the information box below. He made a very nice video on this same painter. So what I did was, in this grid, I divided my little squares, I put the words I wanted, and I was going to go on this format like this, like vertical. But I had more lines than that space. So instead of working this way with the watercolor paper, I'm going to be working in a horizontal shape. I have my ruler over here, and I put in this little paper, I put my words or my sentences, and I counted the letters. So the most I need is 16 spaces. I'm going to measure them in here, and I'm going to just go and make them according to the size of the paper. Since the watercolor has, this paper has this edge over here, I'm going to start counting from the edge because I'm going to cut it. Let's say that it is 17 and a half, and I need 16 spaces. So I made my words. I counted how big I want each square, which I probably want them 3 by 3 inches. And I'm going to see that I have like probably 4 rows. So in my letters over here, I have 5, 6, 4, 7. So I'm not going to use the 7 just because of the lack of space and because I don't want the squares too little. I can always include them somewhere else on another painting or something. The maximum letters has to be 6. So I will select my list, and then I will make my grid and go from there. And by the way, the name of this painting is Once Emerged from the Gray of Night and was painted in 1918. And now we're going to be selecting the words. So the main one to me is paint. So I will be including this one at the top. Never mind. I was forgetting one big detail. So the thing is, in some of his paintings, the squares are exactly aligned. And in others, they are not. They are in the middle, starting like in the middle. So we are going to be doing this as well. Half of the 3 will be 1.5. And over here, same thing. 1.5 and 1.5 and 1.5. So they go like bricks on a wall. We're going to put the ruler over here, and then I just go and make the other lines accordingly, or according to my number dyslexia. And before I forget, the line we're going to erase, if I find my eraser, is going to be this one. I might not have enough lines, but I really wanted to have the squares really big. If you follow this, just make sure that you measure the right one, which by now I'm totally confused. Okay, this one and this one. So it's this one, and I will erase this one. So we have our grid, and we're going to start our words. And the first one I'm going to put in here is paint. I guess because of the spaces that I have now, I will use the word dream. So create will be down here, and then the last one will be bliss. So it says paint, dream, create, bliss. And now, I'm going to select my colors. He has, in some of his paintings, some very vibrant primaries, and then in some other ones has like fall type of colors. In this particular one, he has like, well, a gray bar, but also kind of darker colors. I think I'm going to go more for like the jewel tones, so it's going to be more vibrant than not. So I have my warms, my cools, and I think I'm ready. I'm going to put them in this little spot over here. And now I'm going to think a couple of minutes about how I will do the actual letters, if I want to make them kind of hidden all around the corner, maybe with a Sharpie or maybe with a brush. So I guess I can test or just go like that. I'm going to be testing what exactly I want to do the letters with, the lines. This, I know, is never going to move. It's a very good kind of waxy pencil. But I'm not sure if it is just way too straight, because if you see on his painting, it's kind of scratchy. And for this one, I love the charcoal, but I also know that when you go with a little bit of water or paint, actually, it will move on you. Whoa, this brush just exploded. I think, well, never mind. I think it was just left on the water too long. I suppose this could be fine if I follow it with a little bit of water. And my other option would be with gray paint or any other color for that matter. Like if I get letter T. What do you think? Let me know in the comments what you think, and then let's surprise each other with the decision I made to follow along. At this point, I think I'm going to go with the charcoal. Although I know it's going to move, it's going to be okay because it can make it kind of scratchy. And then I will be painting every little other space with other colors. So hopefully it will turn out the way I see it in my mind and follow kind of close on what Paul Klee intended for us to see. Now I'm going to follow the charcoal pencil lines with a little bit of water, just to make sure that it doesn't move too much when I am actually adding the paint. Another option would be to use the medium, but that would kind of set it completely. And at this point, I don't know if I want it completely unmoving or not. I just want it not too slippery. I suppose if you want the letters a lot more colorful, you can always go and pick a color for the lines of the letters. This is one of those projects that you don't really know what you're going to be doing until you're completely done. Unlike when you're totally following a photograph and you know exactly what you want and you're trying to reproduce the thing exactly. Select your own colors, get very inspired by the lines, by the idea, but with your own twist in color and meaning. All right, I am going to let it dry a little bit. Just as it is right now, black and white, I'm loving it. So in the bottom part of his painting, he has brighter colors. This print is probably a little too bright compared to the original, but still the colors are brighter than on the top part. I like it better because I like bright colors. So let's say that I have my yellow, blue, pink, purple, a little bit of orange, probably this green, and the colors look watery to me. I can see the paper, especially on the larger digital image. There are some dirty or grayish colors, but we're basically just going to go from there. I probably still need, well, the gray and the black to kind of tone down the other colors. And I am not going to apply them in the same order, but I want the set of colors because I like them. If you prefer to be only warms or only blues, just go ahead, because I'm certainly not following that closely. It is not perfect, and it is like scrubbing, scumbling. So it is super interesting to see the brush texture and the color and the lines. Really cool. I can see that he went all the way to the end of the squares. I didn't do that. I went kind of to the edge, but I left spaces, and that's okay. I mean, we're just playing with colors. I have these brushes that are very scruffy looking, so I'm going to use them to kind of like just go around spreading the paint with a little bit of texture, hopefully. And first I'm going to have my paintbrush wet, then I will add the paint and play with it very kind of wet, diluted liquid. I also want to play with the colors in a way that they combine nicely. So if you have a color wheel, you can pick it right now and select the colors that will go better together so they are not too clashy. But that's just me. It doesn't have to be a thing. I want to have the green kind of spread evenly as a focal point. Pretty much every color. I like to have areas where, can you see over here? Areas of the color kind of taken evenly. If you're new here, remember to click on the subscribe button and also tick the bell so you get notifications every time I upload a new video. All you will see in the playlist here is acrylic painting, art journaling, all kinds of fun, free paintings and activities. this brown coating is like antiquing every color, and it's giving it a little more of a moody feeling instead of so bright, because although I love the bright colors, I was not completely happy with the overall look. If you darken things a little bit, it changes the whole perspective and the feeling of the whole painting, and that can be a very nice thing if you want to just kind of give it a little more of a serious feel. It's still in person a lot kind of muted, although in the computer, I mean on the little screen here, I can see that it's still too vibrant, but in person it has been antiqued plenty. I'm going to go around with this to antique the edges a bit more and give it more of a pop to the rest of the colors and the general look. If you like this video, share it in all your social networks. If you want to see more videos about acrylic painting, check this link. And if you want to let YouTube to decide what is next for you to watch, check on this other one.